guys, how's it going, and welcome back to the channel. In this video, we are gonna take a look at some early leaks regarding Season 4, including what could be the theme, a massive collab, which is not gameplay related, but actually very cool at the same time, bringing possibly the biggest theme song ever to the game. We're also gonna take a look at the new gun, the mythic skin of course, the balance changes, and a lot more. So, make sure to watch a full video, and with that being said, here we go. Okay, so first things first, over here we have our first official look at the Mythic MG42, which we have discussed multiple times in the past, but this is our first close-up look of the skin. And like I said in the previous videos, it's insane. It's probably one of the most unique Mythic skins to date, and I'm definitely excited to see it in game. Now, besides that, we also have this teaser over here of the whole draw. We've got the gun and the caricature, which looks insane, and that insane World War II background. So, of course, as we can see, this draw is definitely themed around World War II, and I'm super excited for that, because the last time we were in World War II was back in 2020. It has been that long. Now, all I do hope is that it's not just the draw which is World War II themed, but rather the whole season. Because if it is, that would be super refreshing. Now, taking a step away from the Mythic MG42 draw, if the whole season is actually World War II themed, then it is very possible that we might finally see the Conquest 2020 Battle Pass return to the game. Now, of course, that is just strictly speculation and not confirmed, but it is definitely a possibility. Of course, not confirmed, take it with a grain of salt, we are gonna have to wait and see what does happen, which I really hope does happen, but of course, it is not confirmed. It is more of a thought, which I just, I guess, thought about. Anyways though, going back to the Mythic MG42, this draw is going to have a massive collab attached to it through the Mythic MG42, through a new theme song produced by music legend Hans Zimmer. Now, if you don't know who this is, he has worked on some amazing, very iconic theme songs and soundtracks for movies like Interstellar, Dune, Batman, the list goes on. And also, back in 2009, for Modern Warfare 2. And now he has made one for Call of Duty Mobile as well for the new Mythic MG42. And the song is insane. It's actually very good. So over here it is, take a listen and give me your thoughts on it down below in the comment section. I think it sounds amazing. Take a listen. So, okay, that is the new soundtrack for the Mythic MG42. Give me your thoughts down below. I think it sounds really damn good. Definitely a fan, on my part at least. Anyways though, over here we do have our first look of the normal base MG42 in the game. This gun should have a fast fire rate, good recoil, but the damage might be a bit less compared to other LMGs. But of course, let's wait for the actual stats from Call of Duty Mobile. Now over here I would say is our final bit of actual Season 4 info before we do check out the balance changes, and that is the translated name of Season 4, which roughly translates to War Farewell. Now, of course, this is going to be different for the global version, but this does indicate we are in for an actual war military type of theme, which seems to be World War II. Personally, I'm a fan. Give me your thoughts down below. Anyways though, now let's check out the balance changes for Season 4. Okay, so the Type 19's BSA has been buffed. It has been decreased from 21 to 18. Very nice. If you do enjoy the gun, should make it a bit better. The Growl has been nerfed, so the base ADS movement speed has been decreased, as we can see over here. Growl being nerfed, I think that's okay. The Man of War's Thermite Mag has already been nerfed, which I think a lot of people are going to be super happy to see. So the damage radius has been decreased, as we can see over here. For the S36, the damage has been increased by only 1 on the second. That's not going to do a whole lot. And the lower arm multiplier has been increased as well by 0.1, as we can see, to 1.1. For the Cordite, the hit flinch has been decreased, as we can see over here. That's pretty cool. I'm a fan of the Cordite, so happy to see that over there. Very nice. The MSMC actually got quite a number of buffs. So the headshot multiplier has been increased by 0.2. The chest multiplier has been increased by 0.2 as well. And the hip fire spread has been decreased for MP only. Are we witnessing a comeback? It surely seems like it for the MSMC. Then we do have some surprising buffs for the PKM. The lower arm multiplier has been buffed, the ADS bullet spread has been decreased, and the hit flinch has been decreased. This gun was already very good, and now it's just going to be better. The Tundra has received a nerf, which was expected. Breath hold time has been decreased. It's still probably going to be the best sniper in the game. The Tech-9 has received 2 buffs, so the range has been increased by 2 on the first and 2 on the second, and the hipfire accuracy has been increased as well. For the Halberd Mag, for the Swordfish, the stomach multiplier has been increased by 0.2, so okay. For the Mag 10, the range has been buffed by only 1 on the first and 1 on the second, nothing significant in my opinion. Then we do have our final gun change, which is for the CBR4. The ADS movement speed has been buffed, and the hit flinch has been decreased to 1, so okay. That's all the guns, and now let's check out Score Streaks and BR Colossus. So for BR Colossus, pumps and jet boost has been adjusted. Flight heights will remain the same regardless of what trick players use. For example, super jump has been fixed. Very interesting. Give me your thoughts on that down below. Now for operator skills, utilities, and score streaks, we have the following. So for Havoc and Death Machine, the activation points has been decreased. For gunship, score requirements has been decreased by 100, and for Guardian, the HP has been increased to 650. Then we have a super unfortunate buff for persistence. The score multiplier has been decreased from 2 to 1.8. Totally unnecessary, but it has happened. For alert perk, alert will now detect enemies within 0.2 seconds delay in 10 meters radius. So from 0.8 to 0.2. And then a vulture buff at the end. HP recovery after pickup has been increased from 30 to 40. So okay guys, that is all the balance changes. Give me your thoughts on them down below in the comment section. Are you happy? Disappointed? What are you thinking? I would love to know. And guys, with that being said, that is currently all the latest info regarding Season 4. And well, I'm super excited. It looks like we're finally going back to our roots, a proper World War II military-based theme. I think it's going to be good. But yeah, give me your thoughts down below in the comment section. And with that being said, that is going to be all from me. So thank you for watching. Have a great day, and I'll catch you in the next one.